And now we will learn how to finally pay the sales tax. When do you pay sales tax? Well, it could be either monthly, quarterly, or annually. It depends on your state and your industry. And your tax accountant will tell you how often you have to pay. You could set up reminders using the reminders tool so that you will get a message reminding you that it's time to pay the sales tax. You pay for a tax period. The due date of the payment is always after the end of the tax period. For example, you have January tax from January sales. Then in the next month, you have February tax from February sales. Then during February, you will have to pay for the tax that you accumulated during the previous month. That means at the moment you pay sales tax, the amount indicated as owed does not go down to zero. That's because at the moment you pay, you're paying for the previous month, but you still owe for the current period and the current month. And that means that all the tax from the sales of the current month will be paid in the next month and so on. That's why the tax liability almost never goes down to zero at any particular moment. In order to see this more clearly, let's put in an example. February 4th did 6 editing and 7 video for Candy, and she gave us check number 1787. And by the way, in the practice file, all customers and items have been changed back to taxable. In the practice file, only Candy has New Jersey tax. So if you have been using the same file from the beginning of the sales tax course, that's fine, as long as you update the file to make everyone taxable and to make Candy New Jersey, and then enter the February 4th transaction. Now, before we record the sale receipt, let's open up the sales tax liability report again and confirm. Before this next receipt, we only owe $100.80 to New Jersey tax. Now we'll click Customers, Enter Sale Receipt. We have to go back to February 4 of 2016. Okay, we received check number 1787, and of course it was 6 editing, and it was 7 video. Oops, 7 video. And now the tax is $235, and it's, we didn't choose a customer yet, but at the moment we choose Candy, you can see Candy has New Jersey tax. And Candy is taxable, and so are the items. So from this February 4th receipt, we now owe an additional $176.40 specifically to the New Jersey Tax Department. And then when we click Save and Close, you can see the amount of New York didn't change, but the amount of New Jersey sales tax owed has increased. When we double-click, we can see that the amount we owed for January was $100.80, and now during February, we owe more New Jersey sales tax for this particular sale, $176. These are all very important pieces of information to prepare us to pay the tax. Now, before we show you how to physically pay the tax, let's quickly discuss what will happen. Obviously, the cash in bank decreases. The sales tax payable account and the chart of accounts and the trial balance will decrease by the amount that you pay. And the amount owed to the specific tax agency, in this case New Jersey, will decrease. So, for example, February 15th paid all the New Jersey tax owed from the January taxable sales. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Vendors, Sales Tax, Pay Sales Tax. Now, notice when the window opens up, it's showing all the sales tax we owe to everyone. But we're only paying New Jersey through January 31st. Look what happens to the money amount when I change July to January. As soon as I click down here, notice it changes to only the amount we owed through January 31st of 2016. The date that we're physically writing the check to pay the sales tax is February 15th of 2016. You can leave the check mark here and we'll pretend that we're printing the check later. And of course, the money will come from the cash and bank account. When we click OK, before we click OK, to tell QuickBooks which particular tax we're paying, we click the check mark in the left margin of only the tax we're paying, which is already adjusted for just the date that we're paying for. Then when we click OK, we can reopen the sales tax liability report, push A for all, and notice, even though we collected $277 of New Jersey tax, we only owe, as of February 15th, $176 in New Jersey tax. And if you ask, why do we owe $176? We can double-click and you can see. We owed $100 for January. We owed $176 for February, making $277. But then during February, let me just move it over. Again, we owed $100 for January for a sale in January. We owed $176 for a sale in February. So in February, we owe $277. But then later in February, we paid $100, bringing the balance of what we currently owe to New Jersey tax, $176.40.